In America, we have government of, by, and for the people. If we, the people, have consented to a government that will serve all of us equally, a government that will protect and uphold our God-given rights, as well as the fundamental rights enumerated by our Constitution, it is our duty to renew our commitment to these ideals and to pass them on to those who come after us. These ideals cannot be dismissed as the opinions of flawed men. Our founders had their flaws, certainly. But to use those flaws to condemn their ideals and the greatest constitution that the world has ever seen is both unjust and it's self-defeating. How many of us can even live up to our own ideals? Without the words, the beliefs, and the sacrifices of those few, the world would not have a ringing example of true freedom.
With Joe Biden and Kamala Harris in the White House, we will. Joe Biden and Kamala Harris will lead by example. It'll be science, not politics or ego.
This woman, she's a basket case. It's a big scam.
She's a woman that's been very ineffective, other than she's got a big mouth.
We are not here to tell you how to live your life, how to treat you like a child or a criminal because you go to church or you defend yourself. Conservatives respect people as individuals. We don't divide people based on their religion, their culture, or the color of their skin. We don't shun.
Short on your dough.